I'm Dominic. Thanks for watching Dominic's Woodworks. And today I want to show you my router sled. I already used it with a pin router attachment for the conch shell horns, and I have since used it for another project where it worked pretty well. But you'll see when I get that one done. Today I want to show you how I built the sled and also show you an experimental piece that I did with it. So here's my sled on my router table. It's, well, not the most expensive one, and your mileage and measurements may vary, but I have this board on the back, just screwed to the base, and it rides against the back of the table. And then I got this runner here, and yes, I believe it's softwood. And I only screwed it down in two places, so it's a little flexible here. The reason for that is, well, it began as a proof of concept, and I also felt that if I ever need to kind of shim this by pushing it here and putting another screw or a small nail in it, I'd still have that option, although it's one of the things I don't expect to ever use. But it's running in this slot, and it does shake a little, but in my experience that doesn't really translate to the movement of the bit. But let's move on. Here I have a hold down device, a toggle clamp, Izzy Swan style. I got the design from a video of his. I'll put a link somewhere there. And you can easily download it, print it out, glue it on a piece of, well, I used 50mm plywood, cut it out, glue it together, put some screws in, and there you go. It's not finished. I want to make a hold down with a threaded rod here and a larger blade. As it stands now, it leaves a tiny mark in the wood that it clamps, so I need to put something in between. So, on the bottom I put holes for these T-nuts. I started off with 4 holes to the clamp down from here. Thing is, it turned out I only have 2 screws that are long enough to reach the T-nut, but short enough not to scratch on the surface. So, I kind of decided that 2 screws are enough to hold it in place, and it turns out they are. As for the choice of router bits, this slot is 12mm wide, so both my Cove bit and the Absent V-Groove bit will fit there. You can also use the 12mm Dado bit or the 8mm, which I recently used. So what I'm showing you next is a practice piece. And for that I had this one in this position. I think it would work better if done here, but just check it out. What I want to do is a fluted piece, and if it works I can think about adding stops for the right angle. Basically the idea is to run it over like this, then turn it, run it over again, and to use the sled for added stability, because personally I wouldn't trust myself to move something, especially as small as this, over the bit in a straight line without any curves or dents, which would be very visible on this. I marked the line I want to do, so I got some reference for where to put this, like this, and I think I'll move it in slightly further to get a better grip. Doesn't hold it too well because it's just this one point, so I'll be holding down with my stop block as well. Wish me luck. remember this is a proof of concept, and I think it, well, it kind of proves the concept. This one, it works, but it's not in the best position. You saw under here, I couldn't really do any more on this. I can flip it around, but to do the center, I just held it like this with a push block to try it out too. And it works, but it's not as easy. What I'd also do for cases like this, I had a longer piece and I do want accurate angles, because as you can see, it was much steeper and then I toned it down a little, well, just a little. You could put a piece of scrap down here. Double-sided tape would be worth a try. So you can butt it up against here. And I find it pretty easy to align these, because the sides of the cut correspond to the sides of the slot. If I had this here, I could then move it over, flip it, align, and so on. So I'm pretty happy with this. I still need to upgrade this piece. The basic concept of a router slot works, and at least for these pieces where the fence isn't really an option, yes, you could use a miter gauge, but I don't have one for this table, so right now that's the better option for me. I have a few more ideas for this, and I think some might be implemented with a fence or a miter gauge, but well, I have this now, so I'll be using it, and I want to see how far I can push it. One thing occurred to me as I was moving the sled. On the table saw, if I use my sled, I'm just pushing it forward like this, backwards. I think that's not the way to use a router sled, and maybe I'm stating the obvious here, but the way I'm doing it, put it out of the way. I put my hand on the router table and then push it with my thumb. This way, if there's some resistance and that resistance suddenly goes away, I won't be pushing it uncontrollably with the table, but I can very easily stop, and even if I give a lot of pressure, which I shouldn't do, I wouldn't get it further than the outstretched width of my thumb. Always pushing it like this, and backwards I'll have two or three fingers here, and just pull it back like this in order to have the most control. So I hope you enjoyed this little demonstration and get inspired to make your own. These are really handy to have, and I think they offer a wider range of applications than, well, the router table alone. So let me know what you think. If you build one of your own, I'd love to see pictures. Thanks for watching, and remember to be inspired. And today I want to show you a few highlights of my welding gig. I did record a lot of video, I think about 6 hours, but I decided to cut it down a little and only pick out a few spots where I think I did something that might